Welcome you to the month of comfort.
2
Corinthians chapter 1 verses 3 and 4.
2
Corinthians 1. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy, and the God of all comfort. The God of all
comfort.
I want you to mark that.
Olorun gbogbo itura.
Who comforted us in all our tribulations, mark it, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. Now, if you look at that scripture, you will discover that God is the author of comfort. Two, God is the dispenser of comfort. God wants to comfort you and I so that we can comfort others. If you are naked, you can't buy clothes for another person. You must have a wonderful dress on you before you buy for another person. What you don't have, you can't give. Comfort is part of the Calvary package. The opposite of comfort is hardship. Every one of you, hardship shall be far from you in the
number.
There is marital comfort, health comfort, financial comfort, positional comfort. Now, the Bible is saying, blessed be the God Almighty, the God of all comfort. He wants to comfort you so that you can be able to comfort another. I pray for someone today. And I want a loud amen. This month you shall be comforted. When this amen is going to hold your oil in your hand, in the name of Jesus, you shall be comforted. Please listen very well. In that area where you are hurting, you are hurting terribly, God will comfort you in the name of Jesus. In that area of major anxiety, God will comfort you in the name of Jesus. In that area of lack, in that area of neglect, in that area of frustration, in that area of disappointment, God will comfort you in the name of Jesus. In that ongoing transaction, in that ongoing transaction that you are expecting something great, the God of comfort will appear. In the name of Jesus, concerning your expectations this year, get ready. Concerning your expectations this year, God of comfort will show up. In the name of Jesus. Concerning all your plans for this year, God of comfort will show up. In the name of Jesus. In those areas of pains, God of comfort will comfort you. Where you have been cheated, where you have been neglected, where they have looked down on you, let the God of comfort show up to you. In the name of Jesus. This one is very serious. In that area of serious battle, the God of comfort will defend you. In the name of Jesus. Where helpers refuse to show up, where help refuses to show up, let the God of comfort show up to you. In the name of Jesus. Now, your amen must be louder now. Concerning your family, God will comfort you. Concerning your husband, God will comfort you. Concerning your wife, God will comfort you. Concerning your children, God will comfort you. Concerning your work, God will comfort you. Concerning your business, God will comfort you. Now, I decree upon those who have faith and you believe that God will do this for you. Let the rain of comfort fall upon you. In the name of Jesus. Let the wind of comfort blow unto you. In the name of Jesus. Let the light of God shine upon you. Let the light of comfort shine on you. In the name of Jesus. Let the cloud of comfort cover us. In the name of Jesus. Let the dew of comfort fall on us. In the name of Jesus. All right, ladies and gentlemen, in the name of Jesus, receive the mantle of comfort. Mantle of comfort. Mantle of comfort. Garment of comfort. Decoration of comfort. Decoration of comfort. Receive the ornament of comfort. In the name of Jesus. Now, someone with the loudest amen, receive the message of comfort. After this meeting, you will receive the message of comfort. Receive the cover of comfort. In the name of Jesus. Through all this year, God will make us and our families comfortable. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So shall it be. Jesus, so we pray.